Good morning, boys and girls. It is time for Take Two with Jeannie, the Thursday edition, on July the 19th, 2018. Well, I have to say this. After being gone for a couple of days, it is good to be home. And you know why? Because there's no place like home. It was a nice few days of being gone. Michael had some training for his job, which left me with some free time, something I don't have very often. So it was delightful to be able to actually sit and read an entire magazine without interruption. Those kinds of things don't happen very often. But I started thinking about what home is. There's you know how some people say home is where your heart is, or there's all these different sayings about what home is, you know, that kind of thing. I started thinking about what was home for different ones of us. Now, for me, home right now is Southeast Alabama, and we have a house, and this is where we live. But of course, in all our years of ministry and travels and everything, we've lived in quite a few different places. We've lived in different ministry campuses. We've lived across the ocean, different country, and there were times we had short-term places where we lived and long-term places that we lived. When we were with Youth with a Mission, the missionary organization we served with for 10 years and then went back in 2013 and served another 6 months in Ireland, we've had opportunities to live in little tiny cracker box rooms, and then sometimes we had a whole big place to live in, not too often, but occasionally we would house sit, that kind of thing. But my point being, home is different for everybody. So I'm going to just talk to you about a couple of places home is home for whoever. See, for a bug, an insect, this might be home, right? Okay, there you go. How about for a baseball player? For a baseball player, this would be home. They might consider this home. This is actually Yankee Stadium, the original Yankee Stadium. I borrowed that from Michael's baseball room. Shh, don't tell anybody. Okay, for some folks, it's just living in that little cottage. That might be home. This is their house, okay? That might be home, all right? For a duck, a home might just be a little pond. That might be home for a duck, yeah? Okay. For a bird, a home might be a nest or any number of places that different birds will live in. Some birds live, you know, at the beach, and they live, you know, in water and a lot of the times. Okay, for a fish, it would be water. How about for a ship's captain? For a ship's captain, a big, beautiful cruise liner like this might be home, or a ship's crew member might be home. And then, of course, you know, you think about your nation. And every time I see an American flag, I think, ah, I'm home. I remember after we'd been living abroad for 3 years, and we came home, and we back to the United States, that is, and as soon as we got to the airport, it was JFK Airport, and we turned a corner, there was a big sign that said, "Welcome to the United States of America," and there was an American flag, and all I could do was fall to my knees, literally, and just be so grateful. Tears came in my eyes and thinking, I do live in the greatest country in the world. So that was home for me. How about this? How about after that rain of 40 days and 40 nights, Noah's Ark, all these critters and Noah and his family, that was home for them. Home could also be a family. Look at this, okay? This is, if I look at a picture of me and Michael and my mom, I think that's kind of like thinking about home. Michael with his mother. That's home, if you will. Michael and his siblings. That would be home. Or just any other assorted family members. You see the word family there. Sorry, it's backwards. But that's home. Think about all the songs and books and movies and things that were written with the word home in it. Think about the song Homeward Bound. Home on the Range, Sweet Home Alabama. That's one I've gotten to really enjoy since I've been living here. Take Me Home, Country Roads. I'll Be Home for Christmas. She's Leaving Home. And Our House. Well, house and home, that's the same thing. Okay, how about all the movies, TV shows, books, Little House on the Prairie, Home Alone, 1, 2, and 3, Homeward Bound, Home Improvement, the TV show, Full House, and of course, Pee-wee's Playhouse. That's also a home. Why am I saying all this about home? Well, home could be, as I said, an actual physical building. like this, but home could also be where your heart is. And home, a lot of the thing about the old hymns that were written that said, this world is not my home, because we have the, as a believer in Jesus, as a believer in heaven, we know that when we go, there's going to be something even greater, the mansion in the sky, if you will, and there's something even greater on the other side. And that's a comforting thing to know. But meanwhile, while we're here and we have our homes here, we have a great deal of work to do. And one of those things is, as we're here and this is our home, think about all the ways that you could be a blessing to somebody today. So I'm going to encourage you, boys and girls, to consider wherever your home is at this point in time in your life. A, be content, like Paul the Apostle said, to be content in whatever state you're in, whatever home you're in, whatever place you happen to be, whether it's physically there or in your life, what home is, your home situation, whatever it happens to be content in it and go be a blessing to somebody today. You know, they may not be very content, the person you're blessing, so you may be the only blessing that they have today. So help them to be content in whatever home or whatever state they're in at this time. Hey, subscribe to my YouTube channel, JeanneSigler. And another thing you could do if you just happen to be home today, or even if you're just out and about, it doesn't necessarily have to be home, tune in to my radio station, WRMZ.org. You'll hear a lot of songs about houses and homes on that station. Hey, everybody, I love y'all. And remember, be content, be a blessing, and I will see you tomorrow for the Friday, end of the week, Friday edition. Let me just say this. It was good to sleep in my own bed last night, and it's good to be home. You have a great day. I love you. Bye-bye.